again, everybody. In the absence of Yadmolek, just a quick heads up. The former leader in GG1, the 10-man project, they have had a disconnect, so therefore, we are at it again. So it's safety car now, he's picking up front runners. And everybody's picked up, the server's going down, it's going to be rebooted and restarted. And the start time is going to be pushed a bit, so the nightfall is going to be correct. And then the race is on again. The impact it has had on the positions of the garbage is that because 10-man rockets have fallen off, they are no longer the lead in GT1, they are now number 4. With a grave danger of being catched up by Team Colin Racing 3. Leader in GT1 that is now the Formula Yamaha listed Storm. Behind them is the Team Bernie Ferrari 550. And again, behind them is the 43 from Steinecker. In other news, while I have been gone from the commentating at least, the Black Arrow SimSport car, the Epsilon car, has dropped out. The Black Arrow SimSport car, as I was saying, has dropped out quite a few laps ago. That means they are now the last car on the grid. This restart does mean that they will have another chance at rejoining, but the last restart was their fault, and when they disconnected again, you're only allowed one disconnect in a row. So Black Arrow SimSport, they will have a chance to rejoin. That means that the race at the moment is being led by the FTZ car, as you can see here. Behind them is the Team Kitty car, and the gap between them are 3 laps. Then from the Team Kitty car down to the Team Ezion car, the single driver car of Jeppe Rasmussen. This one. He is 1 lap behind Team Kitty and is now in 3rd position in LMP1. Behind him, as I was saying, that's the Formula Yamaha Lister Storm. Then the Ferrari. Then the 4GT from Steve Steinecker. Oh, very, very close to touching Team Kitty here. Then the Aston Martin from Team Colling. Then the 10-man project, whom are right now disconnected, and then the Corvette from Frank Halbig and Jan Strunk. And of course, behind all these, that is the Epsilon SKD car, which is of course disconnected as well now. The server is now going down now, as you can see. One team that will probably lucrate on this is yet again the Germans. They will gain another lap and they will probably get quite close to the 10-man project now.
And here we are, ready for the start again. In just a few seconds, the drivers will have the green lights and the pace car will pull up ahead of the field. There we go. And try to take up their positions in running order, current running order. Leading the field will be, as we see here, the FTC car. Most of the field is just lagging enormously behind. Ah, there comes Kitty. Team Kitty DK car. And behind him we have a Lola with the team Easier. This the single guy here, Shadowcar. And then now inherited the lead in the GT class, the Formula Lamborghini Yamaha car. After them we have Team Bernie Racing, Ferrari 550. And behind them is Team Stenick, who will be starting from third position in the GT class. And in the fourth place at the moment will be Team Colin Racing 3 car. And the past leader of the GT class, the 10-man project, is now starting in 5th place in the GT class. And 6th and ending the GT class field, we have Karmic Strength. Two of the drivers from the Team German SH team. And then rejoining the race, the Black Arrow Sim Racing team. And they now have a whole field of GT cars that they have to overtake and go up through. And they actually have to do this several times. As I recall, this fight for the lead is not actually a fight for the lead, because I think the FTC car is a lap ahead of the Team Kitty DK car, so there's actually a lap between these cars. These GT cars, the Formula Yamaha and Team Bernie Racing car is actually on the same lap, so this is a fight for position. And look at this, it's the 10-man project that's already climbing up through the field, trying to get past Steyn now to retake third place. Oh, that's a close overtaking. Oh, Steyn's not looking in his mirror, as I can see. Well, the 10-man project got through without any damage. So, the 10-man project has about half a straight up to the Team Bernie Racing car in second place in GT class, and the Formula Yamaha that's leading the GT class. And Team Easy aren't really being left behind by the leading LMP cars. Hey, incident in the hairpin. I think that was Team Kitty DK ran off. This means that now Black Arrow Sim Racing is actually, Black Arrow Sim Sport is actually right behind Team KDDK to unlap themselves for yet another lap. But they are 24 or 25 laps behind, so. Oh, and there he had to let him by. And right now the positions and lap timing on simutils.dk is updated. So, leading the race at the moment. So, leading the race at the moment is the FTC LMP car, and that car has currently done 94 laps. And behind them, it is still in second place. LMP, the Team Kitty DK. With 91 laps, 3 laps behind the leader. Third place is Jeppe with 90 laps in the Team ECR car. And I can see that what I said before is actually wrong, because leading GT is the Formula Yamaha car, and there's actually an entire lap down to the number 2 GT car, which is currently Team Bernie Racing. And right behind Team Bernie Racing, it's Steyn Stenick, and he's only 26.3 seconds behind. So the only real battle at the moment is actually between Team Bernie Racing and Steyn Stenick. And they're separated by 26 seconds. But as we've seen earlier, this can quickly change. It seems a lot of drivers are still getting used to the track, and there's been a lot of incidents. You know from prior that Team Bernie Racing and Steyn Stenick is running pretty much at the same pace as is the Team Culling Racing car. That's one lap behind Steyn Stenick at the moment. And another incident for Team Kitty DK They just can't seem to keep the car on the track at the moment. See if there's any damage on the car. Calling Racing seems to have incidents of their own. They're currently missing a headlight, I think. So they will be going into the pits shortly. As soon as race control notices that they have only one headlight, they will be notified to go into the pits. Oh, they had no lights on at all. They just turned on the lights and it still works. That's incredible. The front of the car is completely pushed in. It looks really unstable. They may have some suspension damage. Team Kittity Gay in second place, still trying to hunt down the FTC car, and prior in the race they've been faster than the FTC car. It's mainly due to small accidents and unfortunate events that they've ended up here in the second place, an entire three laps behind the leading FTC car, so now they really have something to fight for. They still have to get past some of the GT cars that went past them in the start of this current session. And look at the GT car, they're quickly pulling in behind the LMP car to draft the LMP car. This will drastically reduce his aerodynamic resistance, so we can get a much bigger top speed. Let's say contact takes by the GT drivers to quickly seek in behind the LMP cars when they're overtaken to draft and get more top speed. Outbreak. That's a bad move. He's pulling in slightly early in front of the GT car, and actually that removes some downforce from the Ferrari behind him. So if he pulls in front of a car too fast, he's likely to get hit from behind by the car that he's overtaking. So good point. Good move is always to leave the outside lane open for the GT car, so that if he brakes too late, he won't be hit by the GT car. Oh! Big accident there by Team Ezeon. I think the car took the curb really bad there. It just went, he lost control completely. but it's not that badly damaged. He didn't hit the barriers very hard. It'll take him some time to get back into rhythm and establish his pace again. But you do have to watch these curbs in the LMP cars. Contrary to what you may think, looking at the car in this huge rear wing, the downforce doesn't really come from the rear wing. That's just stabilizing the car. Downforce on the LMP cars actually comes from the diffuser underneath the car and the airflow under the car. This means that it's very important to have the right ride height relations and the right ride height on the track. You want to go as low as possible without ever bottoming out. And that's exactly what happens when you touch the curb. The car gets a little bit higher, and it takes more air underneath the car, and then you will lose the vacuum that the usual airflow creates on the car. And in an LMP car, you will lose 50, 60, 70% of your downforce in just that moment. Now only has to overtake the leading GT car Formula Yamaha team to be on a provisional second position, and of course a second position in the race again. And while we've been watching the other cars, the Team Black Arrows in Sport has actually overtaken the entire field and gone up to being leaders in this session. This means that since the last restart and the last pace car, the Black Sim Sport or Black Arrow Sim Sport racing car is the fastest car on track by far. Right now they are lapping just around 2.5 seconds faster than the next fastest LMP car, or the second fastest LMP car. And they are currently just around 60 laps behind the leading LMP car. The next car in front of the Black Arrow Sim Sport is Carbic Storm in the Corvette. They still have 51 laps to catch up with before they'll overtake Carbic Storm. There was an incident for Sten Stenik. We just see it on the edge of the screen here. Right as he was about to be lapped by the Black Arrow Sim Sport car. fact, let's do something funny here, and let's try and go on board with the fastest car on the track at the moment. Let's see what a lap in a fast LMP car looks at like here on the Sebring Waste Ray. You can really see here how fast he can catch up with the GT cars, even though the Kaubikstrom car isn't as slow at the moment as it was in the beginning. Still a Corvette C6R is a very fast car, but the LMP just cruises by as if the Corvette was standing still. Actually, this part of the Sebring circuit is unchanged since the beginning. This straight in this section was never changed from when the track was created. Speed through these, even though they are tight to second gear corners, range from 120 to 150 kilometers per hour. Down the straights, the LMP cars get up to just under 300 kilometers per hour. The fastest of the GT cars will actually reach somewhere between 280 and 285 kilometers per hour on the straight. So the LMP cars are not much straighter, faster in a straight line, but the cornering speeds are just much, much faster in the LMP cars. At the moment we are just 3 minutes away from completing the first quarter of the race, the first 3 hours or 4 hours, sorry, the first third of the race. So we still have two thirds of the race to go. We have actually a new fastest lap by Black Arrow Sim Sports. He lost it there in the first corner, went too wide, but luckily for him it didn't cause any incidents or loss of control. He was hitting the curb pretty hard. He's actually at the moment about half a lap ahead of the FTC car that's in first place. It means that Black Arrow SimSport is actually gaining just about half a lap every 20 minutes. as we speak, the Formula Yamaha, as we speak, the Formula Yamaha car is actually now touching on the fastest GT laps that's been driven in this race. So they are definitely pushing at the moment. Last lap was actually only 0.05 seconds slower than the fastest GT lap. The overall fastest GT lap is still being held by the 10-man project. They have an advantage of 0.01 second. So definitely not much parting these cars in regards to lap times. The 10-man project at the moment is lapping at 1:56 lap times, and the Formula Yamaha now lapping in at just about high 1:54 times, low 55 times. So the Formula Yamaha team is pulling away by a second a lap at the moment, not very much. The team Bernie Racing Ferrari 550 is lapping at 1:55.3, so actually only half a second in lap times between the Formula Yamaha team and the chasing Ferrari 550. And with us here on the TeamSpeak is one of the drivers from the 10-man project.
Yeah, hello. This is Kasper from the 10-man project.
Hello and welcome, Kasper.
Thank you. Well, we just had some trouble, but we are back on the track.
I see. It's good to see you back on track.
Yeah, we just I just had a disconnect. Maybe I think we disconnected from the lobby, but yeah, that's just tough luck, and we are back in the game and just trying to catch up again.
Yes, as I was saying, while we were trying to chase you guys down, being two laps behind is just around the point where you think, this, we can't make this up, it's up to the other guys to lose it, but it's still a race.
Yeah, then we did, actually, but yeah, we moved pretty fast through the field, and then now we're just chasing. But I must say, Les and the Formula Yamaha is going pretty fast right now.
Yes, I don't know what has gotten into him.
No, that's pretty impressive.
He's been complaining about all the buttons on this new steering wheel. We are racing with the what's it called, Sim Raceway S1 steering wheel.
I think he's getting used to it now.
But he is pushing the car a lot also, I can see. He's really going close to the curbs and pushing the car. And as we've seen earlier, with especially the LMP cars, some of the high curbs here are really dangerous.
Yeah, you really have to look out of them, and it's not all of them where it pays off to go hard on the curbs. Often it's better to go around them, actually, to avoid the curbs. But then again, it's a question of the setup, and if you made a soft suspension, then you can go harder on the curbs.
Yes, but slower on the straights then.
Yeah, of course. Right.
Actually, Lasse just put in the fastest lap of the race just a few seconds ago.
Impressive.
Maybe I should just stay here and commentate and just leave him in the car for the rest of the race.
Yeah, just leave him there for the next 8 hours.
Yes, of course, it's going to be dark soon.
Yeah, that's another aspect of the lead right now. It can change very fast, because racing in the dark isn't similar to racing when it's light.
No, I noticed from the lap times yesterday's qualifying was still just about half a second slower than today's qualifying session.
Yeah, well, from my point of view, it's very, very hard to see on this track, and some around the track there is some lighting, but actually for me it just confuses, and it's hard to see where to go actually.
As we were speaking here, the Black Arrow SimSport LMP just overtook you, and that was actually an interesting overtake, because it was really clearly how much better the LMP cars brake and how much more downforce they have, because he was overtaking in a place that you would never normally expect any overtaking, and he drove by without any problems.
No, the difference is so huge.
Yes, and that's also something you have to get used to when you're driving in the GT cars, because you would normally expect the LMP cars to be faster in a straight line too, but they are not actually that much faster. And then when you come into the corners, they just fly by.
They just go around you like they want, actually. Yeah, but as we see, Team Bernie Racing is still hanging on there on the 10-man project.
They've been very fast here since the last safety car. I wonder if they changed driver or changed something in their setup or something else that's different now, because they are doing very good lap times.
Yeah, I noticed that too, and they had a pretty tough fight here for 20 minutes ago when they passed them.
Well, their fastest lap is still only, I think, 0.03 seconds slower than your fastest lap in the 10-man project car.
Yeah, it's a pretty intense racing in the GT class, I must say.
That's what makes it so great. And I think the racing was actually equally as intense in the LMP car right up until the Team Kitty DK started to have some problems just about an hour ago and we had the last safety car period and server restart.
Yeah, do you know what's going on with them? Because they slowed right down on us.
It may be new drivers. It may be new drivers, it may be just, you know, even if you're a good sim racer, you always have to get used to the car, and if you've been out of the car and condition changed, like it's become a lot hotter, or you need some good laps or slower laps to get used to the car.
Alex, the safety car driver on race control here.
Hello and welcome, Alex.
Thank you. Just in case you hadn't noticed, I just wanted to update everyone and say that Team Etion has retired. Jeppe was driving the car alone, and he actually managed just over 4 hours now, and he had to retire. He was too tired, and that's very understandable. That's quite a long stint. I think it's impressive he did hang on to it as long as he did.
Yes, yes. Respect goes out to Jeppe for driving the car for 3 hours and actually taking the car to third place in the LMP class.
Yeah, that's very impressive.
So even though he was driving alone, he wasn't in last place in the LMP category. That's very well done.
And we still have Steen, currently at 6th place overall, I believe 3rd place GT class. He's doing it on his own as well, as far as I know.
Oh, he's driving alone too.
And he's actually doing not too bad.
No, that's very impressive, and I know from myself that after two stints where you
that's
really going aggressive,
you can't.
Then you get tired. So racing for 4 hours straight—that's very impressive, I think.
It's amazing how much damage that Aston Martin car can take without losing the headlights. Oh, very good thinking by the driver there. He just stopped the car and let the LMP car find its way around.
Yeah, that was quick thinking. You'd almost think that Aston Martin designed this car for this race and its rules, being that if you lose one headlamp, you have to go to the pits and get it changed. So it seems like the headlamps are the strongest part of that car somehow.
It seems like it, yes.
I don't know how they can sustain that kind of G-force it's been having, so... good job on that, Aston.
We can congratulate the Aston Martin mechanics on making a car with enormously safe headlamps.
Actually now, I think the car is sad, because viewing it from the front, the air intake looks like a frowny face.
It really does. I think he's gonna pit now, because I think the suspension is so damaged. He's lodged his splitter too, so the car won't turn in.
He has really been fighting, but they're not.
Oh, he loses it again.
Yeah, that car is really broken, but they're not ones to give up. I know they'll go 100% as long as there's even one wheel in the car. They'll keep giving it everything they have.
That's the true spirit of endurance racing. It's not really ever over before the fat lady sings or the checkered flag is out.
Exactly, and that's what we really want to see here.
It's not fitting in!
Wow.
I don't actually even think it's lost the splitter, because he's going quite fast through that fast turn one left hander there.
But I think some of the lights are out, or...
The right-hand headlamp did give out now, I think.
Yeah, I think it just gave up. It's a tough one.
It's a tough one to smash in, but he did it. It took a lot of effort, but now it's out. And of course, according to the race rules, he will now have 3 laps to pit in and fix his car. And I think that will be a good thing, anyway.
It might give Kaufwerk Strunk, or however it's pronounced, the German team, a chance to get ahead. And I think the race between those two cars is, might be exciting.
Yes, this may be the next thing that we are looking for, besides the 10-man project car catching up with Sten Stenik at the moment. But as you say, Alex, if he really is driving alone, he may soon be suffering from a lot of fatigue.
Yeah, and I've been at the judges table for hours now, and I know I had to fill up and get rid of coffee several times already, so he's really hanging in there.
He may have a solution for that nearby, so that when he's pitting, he may be maybe he's taking care of things.
Oh, like maybe a jerry can next to the racing seat or something.
Yeah, or maybe he's had some medical procedures taken care of before the race.
Can we just have a look at the FTC car? Because from my point of view, I can see that Chris is almost catching up with it. It's going really, really slow, I think.
Yes, it is.
I was wondering if it had an accident or something.
The last time was okay, actually. Not too bad, so...
And this one's really bad.
Not sure on that one.
This is 6 seconds slower than it used to go. Yes, he may have had an off somewhere.
Yeah, it was almost a GT lap time.
But it doesn't seem like there's any damage, so we can't have touched the barriers. This lap around, his lap time seems okay. Even though he's nearly 3 seconds behind on the second sector, of course this faster sector time is set by the Black Arrow SimSport car, which is just lapping at inhuman lap times at the moment.
They are definitely going very fast, but they also have a lot to catch up on. They're about 60 laps or so behind the race leader, so they really need a miracle.
At the moment, the only car just remotely keeping up with the Black Arrow SimSport is actually Team Kitty DK on second place. But they also have to catch up 5 laps to catch this FTC LMP car.
Well, guys, I'll leave you to it now. I will get in the car now, so see you in a couple of hours.
Okay, good luck.
Yes, and good luck, Kasper. Well, Alex, how's it been being race control on this race? Have you seen a lot of incidents or having to make some rule arrangements or doing anything to ensure drivers are behaving properly?
I've been a bit more busy than I had expected, especially in the start of the race, where one team dropped out before the first lap, and then again after half a stint or so, we had another restart. So the beginning was quite busy, but I think it was a learning experience for everyone, because everyone rehearsed the rolling starts, and figuring out how to pass the safety car when it goes out, you know, to catch up the field, everyone must pass the safety car except for the leader.
Wave by procedure.
Yeah, exactly. And some people are not too experienced with this, but the few restarts we had in the start made me quite confident that people are kind of learning the procedures and so on, so in that sense it's good. And I'm glad we have the procedure, because it would have been a shame if we had three less cars right now in the race. So, but other than the disconnects, there haven't been any major issues. Of course, a couple of cars have been switching paint, but nothing too extreme, and I haven't had to give any penalties yet, just warnings, and people have done, as I said, fairly quickly, and so no major problems.
Another good move by an LMP guy. We can see how fast they really brake compared to the GT cars. And I actually think the left headlight is out on that Lister Storm there.
It is. It's missing the left headlamp. So they'll have the usual three laps to get it.